Mr. Chairman, members of the faculty, delegates, namaste. Badaro on the Singh family and their staff to organize this event and for having us today. And Dhanyavad for having me. Mere naam hai Johan Prince hai. My disclosures are none, but before I get there, let us go back to where I come from. I come from Pretoria in South Africa. It's called the Jacaranda City, and this time of the year the jacarandas are in bloom. I took these pictures just before we got, or before I left. Fixed fracture deformities and total knee replacement. Now, we can talk about this for 2 weeks. For my audience, I was just to give you a few pointers, because there are a few things that you can do intraoperatively to make it right. So let's think straight about this. As I said, I have no disclosures. Fixed to flexed deformity in TKR. It's a very wide topic, as already says, with incidences of up to 60% preoperatively reported in the literature. So, what are we going to talk about this afternoon? I have 7 minutes left. We're going to talk about what it is, why is it bad, and what can we do about it. What is it? It's an extension problem. The leg cannot go straight. Some of my patients come to me and say, Doctor, not only is my leg painful, but it looks funny. Therefore, it is a sagittal pain problem. But the caveat here is it is seldom two-dimensional. As my predecessors spoke about and the people after me will talk about the combinations. This is a three-dimensional problem. I'm going to talk in the sagittal pain mostly. So, as I said, coronal plane deformities always play a role. There's a combination between bony and soft tissue pathologies. As the previous speaker says, be prepared to do both. Cut right, balance right. So the one gets to the other one. The patient has arthritis from whatever reason. It is painful. The patient starts posturing. He gets muscle spasms. Shortening of the posterior structures, changing in the biomechanical axis, and then accelerating not only the affected leg, but also the pathological process in the contralateral leg. Why is it bad? Apart from looking funny? The aim of any operation, as orthopedic surgeons we should know, is full pain-free function. So, it affects the biomechanics, increased quadriceps contracture, increased energy expenditure, increased load on the contralateral limb, increased load of the lower back, anterior knee pain, later hip flexion deformities, patella alta, the altered biomechanics, leads to an altered gait, increased difficulty in ADLs as we have already seen, decreased enjoyment of the amenities of life, not to mention the increased revision rate of the affected leg, primary on the other side, and we all know the financial constraints we are working in my country. We really do have a problem, and I'm sure you guys do have as well. So what can we do? There are three timelines in the perioperative period that you have an influence on. The pre-op, up to 60%. Remember, high incidence of suspicion. Clinical examination is important. The previous speakers have spoken about that, as well as the radiological examination. But that helps you to plan your surgery. Know what you are in for. Know what sets you have to have. Have a cruciate retaining, cruciate sparing, no matter how you've been taught. If you have a cruciate sparing, have a retaining there. You might have to sacrifice your posterior cruciate anyway. High degrees of the coronal plane deformities, as already says. But the most important weapon, in my opinion, and we'll get back to that toward the end, is your patient. Intraoperative evaluation and grading after the effects of the analgesia and anesthetics has given some of these structures release, and you can see what you are actually dealing with. The difference in sort of technique and your train of thought in the beginning of the operation. In essence, the bigger the deformity, the bigger the correction you have to do, and unfortunately, the bigger the chances are that you have to redo something at a later stage as the deformity will occur. Let's grade it quickly. Grade 1 up to 30 degrees, grade 2 30 to 60, and grade 3 more than 60 degrees. So it matters not what your beliefs are. Is it a TKA or a plan TKA? Is it a bony problem with a soft tissue solution? Is it a soft tissue problem with a bony solution? I firmly believe that it's a bit of both, and you have to plan for that, and you have to be prepared to cut as well as balance. The cuts, two cuts in my opinion that are important, the distal femoral cut as well as the anterior femoral cut and maybe the proximal tibial cut, but we'll get to that a bit later. Remember guys, it's about balance. If your flexion and extension gaps don't balance, your knee will do badly. Extension gap influence extension, therefore the flexion deformity, what we are speaking about. Distal cuts, the distal femoral cut, we won't go into the standard femoral components, 9 millimeters, but it says that for every 2 millimeters extra cut that you make, you get a correction of up to 10%, although with navigation coming in, that seems not to be true, but we don't have time to go into that. Again, the caveat here is not more than 6, maybe 8 millimeters, otherwise it will start changing your joint line and also run into trouble a bit later. The anterior femoral cut, why is that important in sagittal plane deformity? If you put your femoral cut wrong, you'll get your femoral component in flexion and your flexion deformity will not correct in this instance. This is not one of my knees, I got this off the internet. Extra cuts, the tibial cuts, okay? Some people believe in lessening the angle will help with the extension gap, but remember that it influences the amount of flexion that your patient will get out of it, especially people squatting a lot. This is a bushman preparing for a hunt, one of the indigenous peoples of my country. Okay, soft tissues, what can we do? Peel in the sagittal plane. The problem lies at the posterior aspect because of shortening. Okay, so the posterior capsule, the osteophytes, the posterior cruciate in your various knees, and pie crusting, and I do not mean that type of pie crust, but the pie crust that we have spoken about. You can either do it with a needle or with a knife, but as the previous speaker said, be careful with a knife because the knee will give way unexpectedly. So, just to, in summary, Mr. Chairman, I've got 3 minutes left. Total knee arthroplasty in patients with fixed flex deformity. I am using the information. I have been in touch with Mr. Jang, and he said I may use his information. Oh, my goodness, I'm going the wrong way. So, principles, up to 30 degrees, most of the deformity corrects under anesthesia. That is why it is important to have a look at your patient before you start cutting away. Remove the osteophytes, strip the adherent posterior cuts after your bony cuts. The tight collateral remains might have to be released if there's a three-dimensional problem. An oversection of the distal femur by 2 millimeter increments only, guys, and test again. Between 30 and 60 degrees, again, 2 to 4 millimeters as a rule. Posterior capsule, you can go up to the linear sparsa, it's not always necessary to do so. Neither are gastrocnemius releases. You can have a dissection of the posterior medial capsule. And then the patient needs to be immobilized, and that is what I'm going to get to in the last 2 minutes. Mr. Chairman, I have 2 minutes left. Okay. 60 degrees, once you get into that realm, you have to be prepared to go for a constraint type of knee. So always have that in theater. Plan your surgery, guys, before you start cutting. Nobody is as lonely as a surgeon in trouble. And the more serious, the bigger your deformity is, the longer you have to protect your patient. Good. Post-op pain relief. This is very important. You and your anesthetist, you need to talk about this and you need to make sure your patient is pain-free. No pillars under the knee. Remember, you're starting with a flexion deformity. Why put him back into flexion in his bed? That's nuts. Okay, so put it under the heel. The role of physiotherapist and the role of patient motivation. I said in the beginning, the most important weapon in your armament is the patient. If you have a motivated patient, they will rehabilitate. It's just a picture of my physiotherapist and some of the exercises that they do. Extension exercises. So, high recurrence rate has been reported. But all is not lost. It's mostly correct with time, even after surgery. But if we are thinking straight, prevention is better than cure. Mein Apokol, Daniel Wert, Betarum.